ended his career as a superstar.
He should have walked away at that point when he won.
Yeah. Could you imagine?
I want to talk to you about the Hall of Fame. Big announcement yesterday. James Toney, congratulations. Yeah. Roy Jones, Miguel Cotto, and Holly Holm. What do you think?
Look, sure. Is that four? Did you say five or four?
That's four. Who's
does
the fifth
it have
one?
To be, it has to be five, right? Or does they just do four this year?
I think I lost track. Those four I know about.
Hey,
all deserving.
All deserving. You know, the maybe boxing heads scratch their head at Holly Holm and go like, wait, I thought the most significant thing she did was in the MMA
Ronda
cage.
Ronda Rousey put her to sleep.
Yeah, but we forget that she was a hell of a boxer, a world champion, I think, multiple times.
Yep. She dominated. She was the best, and there was just no money. So the opportunity.
Yep.
What's your best memories of Cotto? Best memories of James Toney? Best memories of Roy Jones?
Okay. Roy Jones. Best memory of him. I mean, not going to do it out when he had his hands behind his back. It was definitely thrilling. The body shot knockout of Virgil Hill. He's had a number of highlight reels. You know, the way he fucking iced poor Tasmanian devil, Vinny Paz. You know, a number of them. James Toney, you know, wins over Iran Barkley. Knockout win over Michael Nunn when he was the underdog in that fight. Knockout win over
Evander Holyfield.
Hey, this is kind of lost to everybody but the boxing heads, but a knockout win over what's his name? I want to say it is. I have him on the on this poster right here.
He went up to heavyweight in 40.
Yurov, Vasily Yurov at cruiserweight. A hell of a fight. Fight of the year type of shit. Beat him down, knocked him out, and then yeah, dude, stop in fucking Holyfield, man. When that was a thing.
So that's James. What about Cotto?
Cotto, you know, the drama he would give you at 140, you know, versus, shoot, what's the Colombian's name that they were back and forth? I'm blanking on his name right now, and he deserves more credit than that. Of course, this is also wars with Zab Judah, moving up to 147, just being a hell of a welterweight where you could see that making 140 did in fact drain him. He was stronger when he got up to welterweight. And then when everybody
Burrito
counted him out.
Burrito 2, Mosley.
Yeah, dude. And then when everybody
Mayweather,
counted him out, beating Sergio Martinez.
He fought Paulie.
Yeah.
Saddam Ali ended his career, but.
His career seemed to be a little.
Austin Trout beat him. I was there. Then there was a riot in the stands.
Yeah.
Listen,
those were all towards the end of his career.
No, Austin Trout, he came back afterwards.
He did, but it was still, he had gone over that peak, I think.
But he's a Hall of Famer.
He's a Hall of Famer, yes.
And then, who from the current fighters are for sure going into the Hall of Fame? Active guys, young guys right now, do you think?
Sure shots, right now.
Gervonta Davis, 3-division champ?
I think so.
Shakur Stevenson?
No, not, he, more to prove. Inouye, so. Crawford.
Loma.
Who?
Lomachenko.
Loma, sure. World title after on a second world title challenge, at least in the second
Canelo,
fight.
Canelo, of course.
Canelo, of course.
Spence.
I think so. I don't know if I'm confident enough to say sure
he
shot.
He is for sure. Two belts in 147.
Yeah. Usually you got to have either like a very significant reign or reigns in different weight classes or very significant wins.
He's undefeated.
Yeah, and you know, going to England into the Lions Den to knock out Kell Brook to do it nonetheless.
Busted
yes.
Kell Brook's face.
Busted his face, yep. You know, if I pull out the magazine, we can go through the list. I'm sure there's a couple other names that are sure shots, but those ones we just mentioned.
All right, there you have it. Brian Krause right here. So, for the comments, take back recording.